A man named William Shakespeare left his family to travel to London to work as an actor and playwright, writing more than 35 plays during his career before passing away in 1616. Shakespeare then and now is considered one of English literature's most influential writers. For the past 30 years, Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan, a nonprofit organization here in Saskatoon, has kept Shakespeare's legacy alive through their annual arts festival that takes place right on the banks of the South Saskatchewan River. As always, this festival will feature two full-length plays, but this year there are some new components and projects a part of Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan 2016, and we've got all the details as we go behind the scenes on today's show.
Coming up, we find out what local charities will benefit from this year's Dragon Boat Festival and how much training and discipline goes into the fight scenes at Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan.
Creating local TV that matters to your community. Shaw TV, your local voice.
Saskatchewan actors have been working tirelessly since the beginning of June to bring quality performances to community members at this year's Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan. But before we meet some of these actors and learn which Shakespearean classics are a part of this year's festival, it's important to remember that an incredible team effort goes into making Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan a success each year, as Simon Hyatt tells us in our first story.
I never did think that lady would...
The play is the thing at the Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan site. But making these summer productions happen is an intense year-round effort that hits a crescendo each spring.
We get a tow truck that comes and lifts our tent up in the spring, and all kinds of people, hundreds and hundreds of people and thousands of hours that come down onto site to physically build the site.
Follow me, we're going to go backstage.
Angela Christie is the production stage manager, who has kept busy before, after, and of course during shows.
This also becomes my office, and I've got a lovely view of the stage so that I can call the lights and sound from here. This is where all of the costume changes, props get stored, set pieces that we're using for the other show while one show is on. This ends up being a lot of the times an actor's warm-up area. This is the trip that actors would take to get to their spots backstage. And this is our lovely actor's trailer and deck area where they can come and hang out. It's a little bit different this year because we're in the round, so basically all around the tent is backstage.
The company decided this year to shift away from thrust seating that puts the audience on three sides of the stage to create a more intimate atmosphere.
The audience was up to about 28 feet away. In this case, they're 14 feet away is the farthest audience member from the actors.
Understandably, there are extra challenges running a theater in a tent in one of the busiest areas of the city.
There goes the boat.
It's very distracting. It's hot, it's cold, it's rainy, it's sometimes beautiful. There's noises from the street.
I think it's good for the actors because then they have to be ultra aware, like they have their little antennae out for anything that might obstruct the audience's understanding of the play.
And Brooks believes the setting also benefits audiences, even while they block out distractions, by removing a lot of the pretension of theater.
When you come to Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan, you're coming to a park, and nobody is intimidated by a park. So it tends to be this really wonderful way for new audience members to have their first experience with Shakespeare, and their first experience with theater quite often.
For Big Summer, I'm Simon Hyatt.
We are standing inside the festival tent here at the Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan. Joining me right now is Aaron Hirsch, and he plays Lysander in A Midsummer Night's Dream. Of course, it's a classic Shakespearean play. For those out there who don't know about the plot of this play, how would you sum it up?
Well, it's sort of broken down into a few different through lines. So there's the lovers' scenes, which you're going to see a clip from. And they're running around the forest, and they're falling in love with the wrong people at all times by some sort of intervention from some fairies. Then there's a whole mechanical subplot where they're going to try to make a play that they can do at the Duke's wedding. And so it all gets sort of mashed up together in this ridiculous night of magic and silliness and frivolity and love.
So would you classify this as a comedy, a tragedy, how would a love story?
Well, Midsummer Night's Dream is kind of a cool melange of things, but mostly it's a comedy, absolutely. There's a lot of great different ways we can find to make people laugh throughout the plot.
You canker rat, you thief of love! What have you come by night and stolen my love's heart from him? Oh, fine and great, what? Have you no modesty? No.
And have you been a part of Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan before? And if so, what do you love about it?
Yeah, this is my fourth season. I haven't been in here since about 7 years ago. But I mean, for me, I love being able to work in my hometown. I love being able to spend the summer by the river, and everyone's just here working really hard, having a great time.
It is a really cool, different experience, of course, being right on the river in the summertime. But what type of opportunity is Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan for local artists and actors?
Well, part of Shakespeare's mandate is to hire Saskatchewan artists. So it's a huge boon to anyone who's trying to make a go of being an artist in the province. So it's huge, and the community supports that, which is it's lovely to see.
Let's talk a little bit about working with your fellow actors. What has the experience been like?
Oh, it's always fun. It's when you get to come home and play with your friends that you've known for decades in some instances, and some people I've never worked with before, too. So it's a great experience of new things and old things and familiar things, and it's always exciting. It's always different.
And I'm sure it's hard to pick, but what section or part of the play is one of your favorites to act out?
I like the big fight scene. The big fight scene is great. And then after that, I get a well-deserved nap. So
yeah. So those fight scenes look like a lot of fun, but they also look like you've done a lot of training for them. Can you tell the audience how much training and work goes into those fight scenes?
Yeah. Well, I mean, the little bit that you see was probably about 4 or 5 hours with our fight director, Emma Thorpe, coming in and making sure everything's safe and everyone's comfortable, and little things like making sure the surface is clear and not slippery, and it's just really, really detailed. And then you have to make it look like you're doing it spontaneously in the moment and make it look like it's dangerous but still be safe. So it's a lot of work, yeah.
Well, it looks like a great play. Of course, it's down here at the Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan for the 2016 season. Thank you so much, Lysander, from A Midsummer Night's Dream here at the Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan.
How low am I, thou painted maypole? Speak! How low am I? I am not so low, but that my nails can reach them to the... I pray you, you mock me too, my mother not hurt me!
Still to come, many dogs are rescued from the SPCA, but we meet one who ended up doing the rescuing, and we check out Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan's newest project, a roving play.
Creating local TV that matters to your community. Shaw TV, your local voice.
Community members taking in a play at this year's Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan are encouraged to come down early for the pre-show entertainment, including live local music, and they can take in the beautiful scenery. Speaking of Saskatoon's beautiful river, it will soon be covered in dragon boats for the upcoming Dragon Boat Festival. Many local teams are competing, and it's all in support of two Saskatoon charities.
With complete synchronicity, teams of 25 glide through the South Saskatchewan River, getting a practice in ahead of the FMG Dragon Boat Festival at Rotary Park.
The Dragon Boat Festival is a great opportunity to give back, and as well to be combined with great activity, great competition, where it's not only that competitive part, but the fun, exhilarating, challenging cohesiveness of your team.
On July 22nd and 23rd, 43 teams from across Saskatchewan will be competing out on the water in support of local charities. This year, Ronald McDonald House Saskatchewan and Children's Wish Saskatchewan will benefit from proceeds raised.
Ronald McDonald House is a home away from home for children who are receiving medical treatment. So the funds will go to help with the operational costs of keeping the house running. Both of our charities represent children, and part of being a kid is being active. So it's a great fit for us. Some of our kids are in the boats with us, so we're really excited that it is going to be a family event.
Lots of the kiddos that have had wishes have stayed at the house, and so our causes really do cross over, and we end up serving a lot of the same children in the province. We grant wishes to children between the ages of 3 and 17 years old who have been diagnosed with high-risk life-threatening illness, so it will go to ensuring no eligible child is denied their most heartfelt wish.
First-year participant Mara D. Gasmo knows the value of both these charities and is excited to be giving back to nonprofit organizations that helped her family during a very difficult time.
Well, my son was 15. He was a wish child. He wished for a man cave for the basement. And at the time he got his wish, he was waiting for heart surgery in Edmonton. And during the time when the wish started to unfold, he was in Edmonton waiting for the surgery, staying at Ronald McDonald House, and things just kept getting bumped by the hospital and stuff, so it was a really stressful time. So it gave him the opportunity to think about something nice and exciting and take his mind off of what was happening.
This is the fifth year Staniewski's team, the Tragically Quick, has been involved in the Dragon Boat Festival. Her team is made up of paddlers from different communities throughout the province, but they all have one common goal.
Ultimately, it's about giving back. My very close high school friend, her daughter was granted a wish about 5 years ago now. So Heart and Stroke Foundation was important to me because I have a familial history with it. But for me to now be working with these two charities, it is such a blessing and it's an honor for me and for my team to be a part of something so big.
Last year, the Tragically Quick raised more than $10,000 for the Heart and Stroke Foundation and are well on their way to reaching that goal once again through family and corporate support. Gasmo's team, the Scotiabank Strokes of Genius, is still actively fundraising. Scotiabank will be matching their donations, something Gasmo is appreciative of because she knows how much money both charities need in order to help families.
I know that the average wish is about $10,000, give or take, depending on what kind of support they get from the community. So it'd be nice to see our fundraising go to Grant a Wish. I also know that the cost to stay at Ronald McDonald House is very, very low because of contributions from charities and that type of thing. So I know it's going to a really good cause.
Aside from raising money for worthy local causes, the FMG Dragon Boat Festival is a great way to spread awareness about the charities involved.
We are excited, of course, for the fundraising aspect and to be able to raise money for both of our charities, but also to bring awareness to the people who are participating in the event about Ronald McDonald House and Children's Wish and who we are and what we do with the children of Saskatchewan. So I think it's a great opportunity and a great platform, and we're very grateful for that.
It's an opportunity for the families that we work with to come down to the river, kind of take in the festivities of the day. There's some entertainment, some food trucks, things like that. So we'll have some booths on the day of, so just a great platform for us to share information.
The FMG Dragon Boat Festival takes place July 22nd and 23rd at Rotary Park.
It's where you live. Shaw TV. Your local voice.
Julius Caesar is a well-known Shakespearean play. Of course, here at this year's Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan, they've done a pretty cool adaptation. Joining me right now is Heather Morrison, and she plays Antonia of J. Caesar, is what we're calling it at this year's Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan. Let's start right there, Heather. It's Antonia and not Antony, which some people may be familiar with from the classic Julius Caesar. Tell us about the different parts of this year's play.
Sure. Well, I mean, normally Julius Caesar obviously done with a mixed gender cast. It usually also has a larger cast too, but we pared it down 7 characters and they're all female. And so some of the names are the same. Brutus, for example, Julia Caesar, and then yes, I am Antonia. So it takes place 400 years in the future. And well, there are still men in the world, but the women have taken over. So, and what we're looking at here is the hierarchy, just like Julius Caesar, you know, in charge of the Romans. Here's our Julius Caesar, she's in charge of us here, the Romans in, you know, 2400. And so you still can put that same story in, but yeah, it's with women and it's in the future.
That is so cool. So what was it like doing this play with an all-female cast?
Well, you know, it's so interesting because it doesn't really matter to me that we're all women, right? Because actors are just actors, and it's someone that you're playing with and you're playing off of. But what was so interesting about this is the fact that we are all women, and here we are getting to speak words that we never thought we'd be able to say in our lives. Like, let's slip the dogs of war, friends, Roman, countrymen. Those are two words, et tu, Brute, right? And so we're so, so excited about this opportunity that everyone just came in with so much energy and so much excitement. And I think we just like plowed right into this play. And so I think that's been the difference with the fact that it's all female.
Yes, you guys are definitely fierce from those fight scenes that I just saw. There must have been a lot of training and rehearsal that went into those fight scenes.
Yeah, I worked with a nutritionist, actually. And yeah, I did work out a lot. And now I just eat a ton to keep my energy up because, yeah, it is really exhausting. But again, so much fun because I've never had the opportunity to have a fight like this in a show before. And who knows if I ever will again. So I'm definitely giving it my all. Julius Caesar is normally a political tragedy, right? It's usually a political drama. What is so interesting about taking it and putting it from the perspective of women is women are more typically allowed to show emotions. Mm-hmm. And so there's a lot more of like the actual mourning of Caesar and the grief that comes out. You see really Brutus, you see Brutus's struggle a lot more. And so it's become more like an emotional drama. Mm-hmm. Yeah, not too many laughs in the play, I will admit, but a lot of really cool looks, and the music is amazing and everyone's just giving it their all. I think that if you've never tried Shakespeare before and you happen to like movies like Mad Max, come on down and check it out. I think people are really gonna love it.
And what do you think about the actors getting to be in the round and having the audience fully around them as the play goes on? Because I think that's a pretty cool aspect.
Yeah, I mean, it's a totally different experience for people. I think there's not much in the round that happens here in Saskatoon. I think that it allows you to make really big choices because you have to be acting through your back as well, so people can read what you're doing from behind. I think that it just makes the show really exciting. As you can see with Julius Caesar, or Julia Caesar, it makes it feel like an arena. So you're kind of watching these women fight it out. It's pretty fun.
That's the perfect way to describe it. As I was watching your fight scenes, that's exactly what I felt like. I was right in the action. So it's definitely a great experience to come and check it out. Heather, thank you so much for taking a few moments.
Thank you.
There to bring it home. Shaw TV, your local voice.
On any given day, you can see people with their four-legged friends on the Meewasin Trail. And coming up, we'll learn how a new Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan project is also utilizing this trail. But first, each week, Shaw TV highlights adorable adoptables from the SPCA looking for their forever homes. In our next story, Simon Hyatt introduces us to an animal who actually saved the person's life who adopted her.
What do you think, Maya?
Maya is an extremely affectionate dog.
No kisses, no.
And while her slobbery method of demonstrating love isn't always appreciated, it's also been the kiss of life for one of her owners.
She's always been very inquisitive with my seizures. There's times when I'm unconscious on the couch and she'll come and stand on my chest and lick my face just to bring me out of them.
Penny Carlson suffers from a disorder that leads to her having up to 30 seizures a day. In addition to helping her through these incidents, on one occasion when they were out for a late night walk, Maya's responsiveness may have truly been a lifesaver.
I had a seizure and I fell down a few steps and Maya ran up the stairs, scratched at the door of our apartment. And alerted Colin, and she showed Colin where I was.
I hear scratching and barking, so I get up. She's at the door. Penny wasn't around. So I followed her down the steps. She jumps on Penny's chest, gives her a lick. She woke up.
Penny and Colin had been looking to adopt a dog for a while,
When they learned Maya was at the SPCA, they set up what was supposed to be just a meet and greet. But Maya apparently had other ideas.
When we were on the meet and greet, I took her out back, just on a leash. She headed straight for her truck, and was going to jump in there. I didn't have an idea of the truck or anything, but she led right.
No one knows exactly where Maya came from originally. She was found walking down 20th Street and taken to the SPCA. The future is more clear for her, however, in her forever home.
She won't leave us alone. When it's bedtime, it's Penny, Maya, me. And she doesn't move the whole night. She'll sleep right between us.
And it will likely come as no surprise that when the family takes its next step with a wedding later this year, Maya will once again be in the middle of things.
We're gonna put on her leash or collar. We're gonna put a little snap on there at the rings, and Penny's daughter is gonna be walking her up the aisle.
For Go on Shaw TV, I'm Simon Hyatt.
Summer is officially here, so it's time to take in some theater by the South Saskatchewan River. And at this year's festival, they are taking it even closer to the water's edge with their roving show. Joining me right now is Joshua Beaudry, and he, of course, is no stranger to this festival. But this year, he's taken on a little bit of a different role. He is a director of the roving show. So Joshua, before we tell community members what play is actually moving around the Meewasin Trail, why did you decide to take on the directing role?
Power.
Oh.
I wanted to have all the control. No, I just, I love theater, and I love working with actors. I love great directors, and I just aspire to try and get there eventually one day. So it was a great opportunity.
Excellent. And you actually chose to do The Tempest as your roving show. Tell us a bit about the play and what spin you have on it.
Okay, so the basic setup is that we have four modern-day mechanicals who come down to Shakespeare expecting that they will just be put into Midsummer Night's Dream, but they're rejected by the festival, so they decide to stage their own rogue show off-site. And so they, through process of elimination, choose The Tempest.
Okay.
And then stage it with whatever props they have available in their trucks.
And like I mentioned, it's a roving show, so it is moving down the trail. Where does it start? Where does it stop? Go for that.
Well, it starts down here at the dock, where the Prairie Lily launches from.
Yeah.
And then it just follows the Meewasin Trail in and around the festival site.
Very, very different. I myself have never heard of a roving show. What are the challenges when directing a show that is constantly moving?
One is that there's constantly people coming in around, there's vehicles that move around, children that shout, people that gawk and stare. They're actually, you know, at first I was a little bit nervous, but my actors are so brave, they just dove in and went with wild abandon, and it's been pretty fun, amazing to watch them work.
And well, from the scene that we just saw, it looks like a really fun piece. So what are the maybe privileges and benefits to having a show styled like this?
The privilege is that our set is the most amazing set I've ever seen.
Fair enough.
The green is beautiful this time of year. The trail is amazing. And even as I'm traveling through it with our test audience, they're going, I've never been through this place before. Mm-hmm. And it's pretty beautiful. So epic backdrop.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
The beautiful South Saskatchewan River.
That's right.
So when community members come down to see this roving show, a brand new aspect of the festival, what do you hope they really get out of a show like this?
Oh, I think a sense of fun. There's a real sense of creativity because there's this sense that everything's happening on the fly.
Mm-hmm.
And also there's a real improvisation element to this show as well because people could just walk right through the scene. And so the actors are really good at incorporating that and working with the things that happen to them, because it's not guarded, you know, like being in the tent where there's a front of house and people are stopping other people from coming in. Anybody can wander.
It sounds like a lot of fun. Another great play to add to this year's festival. Come check it out, The Tempest. It is their roving show here at Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan. Head to shakespearesass.com for all that information and, of course, to get your tickets. Thank you so much, Josh.
Thank you very much.
Hey, good, be patient.
When the sea is
good, yet remember thunder. Whom thou hast aboard.
We're there to bring it home. Shaw TV. Your local voice.
Part part of the mandate of Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan is to hire and support local actors, but new to this year's festival, University of Saskatchewan drama students will also get the chance to work with one of the best theatrical companies in Canada, thanks to a partnership with Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan. Here's Simon Hyatt with more on that story.
As thousands of University of Saskatchewan students convocate this week, they are filled with happiness and pride, but possibly also dread. While students in some fields may have their careers mapped out, in others, especially the arts, the future may be cloudy.
Students coming out of university just all of a sudden hit a wall. There's this sort of disconnect because they've been so busy studying their craft for the last 4 years that all of a sudden they open their eyes and go, great, now next stage, but I don't know how to do that.
A new partnership between the University of Saskatchewan's Drama Department and Shakespeare on Saskatchewan and funded by the Heather and David Foundation is hoping to ease that process through apprenticeships.
To give them that experience, that real world feel of what it takes to do this for a living, it gives them a leg up. And anytime you can do that, you can transition from the theoretical to the practical, that transition period, you can ease it a little bit, it results in great success.
When they first emailed me, I was like, what? So exciting, because I'd been doing a lot of the independent shows, a lot of the Live 5 shows, Fringe shows, stuff like that. And this is a substantial jump up a level, which is fun.
Emma Thorpe has always been drawn to working in fight choreography, and now we'll be getting the opportunity to do so with some of the best material in the dramatic world. She will be helping stage the fights for J. Caesar, an all-female retelling of the classic story this summer.
We don't get to see a lot of female fight directors and fight choreographers here, but we also don't get to see the women fight at all a lot. So like we get to see 7 women do a whole bunch of really cool fights, female fight choreographer, which is really exciting. It's lovely.
And it was important to Brooks that the opportunity to apprentice was opened to students interested in not only acting, but all positions in theater. This year, there will also be participants learning about theatrical music, stage managing, wardrobe, and being a festival technician.
Theater is a really complex beast, and it's really important for us to remember as people who are choosing who gets the opportunities, to remember that actors aren't the only ones who need the opportunities.
The program is funded for the next 3 summers, with at least 4 apprentices taking part each season. For Go on Shaw TV, I'm Simon Hyatt.
It's Where You Live. Shaw TV, your local voice.
Experience some of Shakespeare's classics at this year's Shakespeare on the Saskatchewan, including their brand new roving show that takes place right on the water's edge. For more information and tickets, head to shakespearesask.com. Thanks so much for watching today's Go on Shaw TV. I'm your host, Janella Hamilton. Bye-bye for now.